I know it's a weird question to start with, but am I looking healthy? Or at least fit? Fit enough to walk, talk, eat normally like you all do. But what if I tell you that the scenario was completely different around 2 years back? Let me take you to the flashback, my life-changing experience. I still remember that day when I was as crazy as always, running here and there, playing pranks, got punished by economics teacher, went for swimming. But there was something unusual happened with me that day. I mean, there was something new going with me. That was, I was being affected by a disease called Guillain-Barré syndrome. Now you all must be wondering that, what is it? Actually, it's an autoimmune disorder. When our own immune system starts attacking our own body cells by considering them as a foreign material. So now we know that what is Guillain-Barré syndrome, then we must be wondering that how is it dangerous? Actually, Guillain-Barré syndrome is a ascending paralysis situation which enters in your body right from your toe, and it keeps rising and reaches your mind till the path that comes across our nose as well. And when a person is in the state of Guillain-Barré syndrome and it reaches its nose and it was not being provided with a ventilator, then we can say that situation for the patient come possible to the death. I mean, it won't be able to survive, it's not being provided with a ventilator on time. I firmly believe that whatever happens, happens for the best. In fact, those 8 days which I spent in the NICU could be worst or the most terrible days for most of the people. But for me, those 8 days took me towards my passion. The most terrible, or you can say the most memorable night was the first night which I spent in the Fortis hospital, because that on the same day oxygen cylinder was inserted in one of my nostrils and there was already a food pipe inserted in the another one. So I was feeling like a bit abnormal that day. But the doctor, thank God, I'm lucky that Dr. Pangil, my cousin, who was pursuing PhD that time, to stay with me for a night in the pediatric ICU. So after 12, when all the doctors left, I cannot have words to explain the situation or the feelings which I was getting that time. Like I can say that I was feeling like any breath of mine could be the last one. So after 5, my parents came to see me. But suddenly I passed strong signals to my cousins to not allow them to come inside and look for me, because I knew that my parents won't be able to see me suffering through that pain. And I always observed that during those days, my parents' reaction is directly proportional to my outlook. So I always try to show myself in the best manner I can. By the way, let me share something with you. You know, I was always try to make or pick out funny things from my surroundings. There's an incident that happened with me in the hospital. I was lying on my bed in my compartment, and that was an ordinary day. Suddenly, there's some shifting going outside my compartment. Actually, one patient was being shifted from his compartment to the another one. But for some time, his stretcher was left in front of my compartment. And he suddenly turned his head towards mine. And instantly, I passed the gesture like, and he got shocked. I mean, he kept staring me till the end. So that's how I used to cheer up those people who are getting lower and with whom I feel like they are also suffering with the same stage which I was, or even more worse than mine. In fact, when every day my daughter came to do regular checkup of mine, I used to tell him, oh come on, like not actually telling him because I was not able to do so, but I was just trying to explain him or express my feelings that I don't want ventilator now, I can breathe on my own, so please remove it. And for my surprise, one doctor was the most experienced one, believed in my willpower, and decided to relieve me from my ventilator a day before it was decided to. And I lived up to his expectations. I was recovering extremely fast, that it comes or it seemed to be a miracle for many of the doctors present over there. You know what? One day I danced despite on being on ventilator. Actually, I felt like there's a sensation which actually came after so many days. And those sensations, I feel like that I'm able to hold my waist now. So my heart told me to show some belly moves, and I did that. And in fact, one doctor who joined me while I was doing that. There was another day when some doctors decided that my compartment should be shifted. And now I was there were three compartments in my front, and although I was not in a good state, but I love to observe everything, and I used to always look out for the well-being of the people. So I was normally sleeping on a bed, and I was observing the three monitors which were lying in the three different compartments, and I suddenly felt like there is something wrong in the last monitor because it was showing some different color than the normal monitors do. So when my doctor came to me for doing my checkup, I tried to explain him that please first go and look in that compartment. I think that something is wrong with that patient. I tried to explain this to him, and actually, I made him go there, like I forced him to do that, and he went and he came back and he said to me that, are you silly girl? You two are on ventilator, and despite of taking care of yourself, you are still caring about others. By the way, that lady is okay. So I passed him a little smile, like, okay, thanks. But you won't believe, the same day that lady died. I don't know what was the thing, but my intuitions proved me true. Now, anyways, day by day, my condition was getting better, and I was recovering. Like I was able to, I started feeling moves in my hands, and I used to console it to others. I showed my fist to tell all people that to have faith on God and be powerful. I know the all incidents might seem to be very scattered in front of you, but if I will tell you that what those incidents led me to, then you too will realize that the God has designed a beautiful story which led me to my passion. Eventually, I felt like I didn't want to be a doctor, which was my childhood dream. Rather, I want to be a philanthropist. According to me, I used to believe that doctor is the only one who can relieve others from their pain. But by spending those 8 longer days in the MICU, I realized that no, doctor can only cure the physical health of people. But I wanted to seek into more deep by healing others' pain, or by making others feel light by their heart, or by making others laugh. And I suddenly thought that that's all what I was doing throughout 8 days. But I was unaware about that. So I was doing that like by imparting strength to the patients, by imparting strength to my relatives, to the relatives of the patients, and by making doctors laugh on my pranks on my activities. So that's how I got to realize my passion. But at the end, the message which I would like to convey is that whatever happens for the best. Now I would like to sing a few lines from a favorite song of mine, which my elder sister used to sing in front of me to build hope in me. So here I goes. The struggles I'm facing, the chances I'm taking, sometimes might knock me down, but no, I'm not breaking. I may not know it, but these are the moments that I'm gonna remember most, yeah. Just gonna keep going, and I gotta be strong. Just keep pushing on, because it's always gonna be another mountain, and I'm just gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I can.